Grab your tea, grab your coffee, and if you're vegan, grab your water, because I don't discriminate. Welcome back to Chit Chats with Charity. My name is Charity, like love and donations, and I accept both. Before we get into this video, y'all, look at how cute this cup is. It says Boss Lady, and then on the inside of the cup, it says, I'm not bossy, I'm just the boss. I just think that is the cutest cup. I got it from Walmart for like $3.99 because it was on clearance. Get you one. But on a real note, this video today is gonna be about 5 steps on how to ask for help if you're struggling or dealing with anxiety or depression. So if you haven't already, I would recommend that you would go and check out the video that was uploaded right before this one called My Story with Dealing with Anxiety and Depression. And then you can go ahead and continue watching. So the first step that I want to talk about is understand and know when you need to ask for help. So for me personally, I was like, I'm drowning. I am overwhelmed. I am anxious, but I got it. I can handle it. I can do this. And there are times where you have to like encourage yourself to not give up, to not quit. But I had to realize that I was in an unhealthy state and I needed someone to be there for me. I needed someone to pull me up and help me. But I was too afraid to ask for the help. I knew I needed help. I was in denial about asking for it. Like, oh, it's probably not as bad as I think it is, so I'm gonna handle it on my own. And even if you feel even in the slightest bit overwhelmed, ask for help. I understand that depression can be a medical chemical imbalance in your head, but for me in my case, it was because I had a lot on my plate that I was trying to handle and try to deal with on my own. So the first step is to understand and know when you need to ask for help. The second step is to know that it is okay to ask for help. So for me, I thought like maybe if I ask for help, people are gonna see that I don't have it all together and people are gonna think that I'm weak. And that is not true. It takes a lot of courage to ask questions because it's also saying that, hey, I don't know something and I didn't wanna feel like I didn't know how to handle it. And so for me to overcome and get through depression and anxiety, I had to know that it was okay for me to ask for help. You also have to understand that by you asking, you're getting stronger. So yes, it's okay to not be okay. Yes, it's okay to feel weak. But by asking for help, it's only gonna make you stronger. It's not gonna hurt you. It's not gonna harm you. The next I'm gonna say is to go to someone you can trust. So first, understand and know when you need help. Second step is to know that it is okay to ask for help. Third step is to go to someone you can trust. For me, when I was going through anxiety and feeling depressed, I was surrounded by a whole bunch of people. I was in church, I was with friends, I was in school, I was around my family, but yet I still felt alone. So just because I was in the company and presence of a bunch of people didn't mean that I felt that connect with a bunch of people. And so if you are feeling alone or lonely, yet surrounded by a whole bunch of people, find the people that you can trust. Because even in your circle, there may be people feeding you lies. They may be people feeding into your insecurities or even you, giving you negative thoughts. If you have some of those people in your circle, either cut them off gradually, cut them off immediately, or just don't listen to their advice. Find the people that you can trust, that you can confide in, that you know won't throw your issues back up into your face. Even if it's just one person, find that person and then release onto them. Also, if you're like, I don't know how to do that, I don't know who's in my circle that is a snake, go and check out my video call, Check Your Circle, because oftentimes it could be the people in your circles that's triggering you. So check out that video if you need help on to know who you should and should not have in your circle. The next one I would recommend is to find a counselor or a therapist that can help you. And so for me, when I kind of got to my breaking point, that is when I realized I need help. And so when I went to the doctor, they offered me a psychiatrist. And so I want to let you know that there's a difference between a psychiatrist and a psychologist. What I needed was not medicine. Some people may have a chemical imbalance, so what you may need is medicine. And a psychiatrist is the one that can provide you with that medicine. For me, I didn't need it. I was depressed and overwhelmed because I had a lot on my plate and I was holding on to so much. If someone said something that hurt my feelings, I wouldn't tell them. I was very passive. I held on to a lot of things and didn't release not anything. I would write it in journals, but it wasn't enough. I needed to open my mouth and speak out about it. And therefore, I personally needed a psychologist. A psychologist is someone that is there to help you kind of float through your thoughts, to help you organize your thoughts, to help you get it out, to help you feel the emotions. A psychiatrist is the one that can help provide treatment, whether that's through medication. That's what a psychiatrist is for. So if you need a counselor or therapist, there are so many that you can find. You can go to pastors. There's counselors at schools. If you're elementary through college, there are counselors. So find someone not only that you can trust within your circle, but go to someone that's qualified in this area. Even if it is a psychiatrist that you need or a psychologist, don't feel ashamed, because that is something that I also was like, oh no, cowboy. When the doctor told me, like, hey, I think you should check out, you know, a psychiatrist. I have one that I can recommend you to. I looked at my mama like, do he know who I am? And then I had to humble myself and realize, like, Charity girl, you really do need help. And it is okay. It is okay to not be okay. It is okay to go seek professional help. Stop trying to do stuff on your own. But I would recommend that if you are going to go out and seek for professional help, do your research first. And if you feel like this is too much, I can't do the research on my own, tell someone and hopefully they can help direct you through it. Talk to your parents, talk to your siblings, talk to your guardians, and those that are closest around you. So let's go over all of the steps. So the first step is to understand and know when you need help. The second step is to know that it is okay to even ask for help. The third step is to go to someone that you can trust. The fourth step is to seek out guidance, whether that is through a counselor or a therapist. And then the fifth step I want to tell you is to find community. So while I was surrounded by a bunch of people, I wasn't letting people in. And in order to have a community that is fully functioning, everyone feels loved, everyone feels cared for, just like people are letting you into their community, you also have to let people into your community. And so even though I was around a bunch of people, I wasn't open about what I was really dealing with to a bunch of people. And I find that when you find your community, that's when you can find the root of your issues, and then you have someone there alongside of you to help encourage you through it, to help hold you accountable. So let's walk through all five steps together. The first step is to understand and to know when you need help. The second step is to know that it is okay to ask for help. The third step is to go to someone that you can trust to talk about your issues. The fourth step is to find a therapist or a counselor and to know the difference between a psychiatrist and a psychologist. Because depending on what guidance you seek, one can be prescribing you medication if that is what you need, or another one can be just listening and allowing you to help filter through your thoughts, but also to help release it and understand your thoughts. So just to know the difference between both of those. And then the next is to find your community. You're able to do life together in a much more efficient way. I hope that this video has encouraged you, has given you hope in order to move forward in what you are dealing with. And I want to encourage you that this is not the end of your story. This just may be a pause, a semicolon, but there's more. Allow the author to continue writing your story. So you already know the drill. Chit, 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 chat to Charity.